We have upgraded this design that we've done a couple of years ago, and we're using the latest apps that Canva has installed. Let's jump in on Canva and recreate this design. If you remember this video, you would know how long it takes to make a split design using Canva. So you're going to scroll down and open up your apps. You're going to search for the Typegradient tool. So you can either type Typegradient over there. I have Typegradient, so I'm just going to open it up, and then I'm going to add the name of the business. So this is where you add your text. The initials are capital letters SEA, and I'm going to change the font to Archival Black and select the regular and go back. And then you can leave the alignment as it is. The height you can leave because it's just one line. And then you're going to move your pointers to the middle. So you're going to click and hold the pointer and move it to the middle and add it to the pointer in the middle. That way you're getting two lines. Then you can move the pointers any way you want. So if you wanted to slash it right there in the middle like that, you just move your pointers that way and it's done. So you're gonna scroll down and click and add to design, and then you make the letters bigger, align them and add them in the middle. You can do exactly the same to add the text for the slogan, which is for better learning. And you see how it looks like happiness. Then you can move your pointers so that they are also now slashed. It's stupid when I'm alone with you, I never feel lucid. I wish I wasn't struck by Cupid. I wish when I first saw you, I knew this. Press L for a line, and then you can change the line color and make it white and make the line a little bit bigger, because you're going to use this line to slash. With you, I don't ever feel calm. I can feel the sweat inside my palm. Depending on how big a slash you want, you don't understand the pain it brings. You can adjust and make changes as required. If you want to add like a slash, you can always go to your elements and search for line. And the line that we used was created by Ouch, and it's under your graphics.
Silhouettes of you are like a taunt. Never really know just what you want. With you, I don't ever feel calm. I can feel the sweat inside my palms. Play with me like cats and a string. You don't understand the pain it brings. You don't.
This is if you wanted to add the slash, but it's entirely up to you. You're going to then download the design as a transparent background, and then you're going to upload it back to Canva to take away the extra line that we've added on here, the white lines. Add an extra page, re-upload the design back to Canva. There's that white line that you see over there. So you're going to select edit photo, and then you're going to go back to the old editor. It takes away the white shapes that you've added on here, and then you're gonna use your background remover, and then your design is done. I think it looks stunning. You let me know in the comments below, what do you think? But again, it's a choice. You can have one without the slash, you can have one with the slash. a graduation cap on. It depends on what kind of design you would like to add. So if you want to convert this to a 3D, it's fairly straightforward. You open from computer if you have your own PSD file. If you're using templates from Photopea, you just open a Photopea template and you pick any template that you would like to use. You click on the link for the template and you're going to double click where it says your logo here. You look at how you need to place your design. You just click to hide it. Then you're going to go to your logos that you've downloaded from Canva. Add it to your design. You can make it big as the example showed you. Just make sure that it fits the canvas. And you're going to press Command S or Control S. Or you can always go File, Save as Smart Object. And then once it has updated and saved its smart object, you're going to click on your black logo. And you have your gorgeous, beautiful design that you've created. So you're going to go File, Export as a PNG or whichever format that you would like to export it as. I do have a Canva course on Udemy that has a whole section about designing your logos. And it's not only that. There's also animation, etc., etc. Sailful English Academy, let us know what your thoughts are on the design. Thank you so very much to join me on this video. You can always go watch the original video that we've created of how you create a slash logo using Canva. I will see you on our next video.